Good afternoon. Today we're going to go over a concept called laddering, L-A-D-D-E-R-I-N-G. Laddering is a concept of how to spread out investments over time in fixed term instruments, such as certificates of deposits and bonds. And the problem comes about, let's say you have $50,000 to invest. And just as an example here, we're going to say that we're between five investments we're trying to make the decision. 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, and 5 year CDs. Now, banks are in the business to make money. Banks want your money for longer periods of time instead of shorter periods of time. So they'd rather have money for 5 years than for 1 year, because they can make more plans if they have your money for 5 years. They can make more auto loans, more home loans, just their capital structure is more stable. And so banks, the longer you put the money in, the higher the interest. And just for an example, we're going to say that a 1 year CD pays 1%, 2 year, 2%, 3 year, 3%, 4 year, 4%, and 5 year, 5%. Obviously, they're not spread out this exact same way. If I take my entire $50,000 and invest it at 1 year, the biggest advantage is that I get my money back in a year. The biggest disadvantage is a really horrible interest rate. If I lock my money up for 5 years, the biggest disadvantage there is it's locked up for 5 years, but the biggest advantage is I get a much higher interest rate. And so the concept of laddering basically says, let's spread out this money over time, and we create kind of a ladder of maturities. And so for each of these, what we're going to do is we're going to deposit $10,000. And this really helps our flexibility, and we end up with an average yield of 3%. But the true beauty of laddering comes about as the ladder ages over time. So 1 year from now, my 1 year CD 1 year from now comes due. So I have this $10,000 back in my pocket. My 2 year CD that is a year old acts the exact same way as a 1 year certificate, because it's a 2 year certificate, it's 1 year old, it has one more year to go to maturity, so it's going to act the same as a 1 year certificate. These interest rates, when you first establish them, are fixed. 99% of the time they're fixed. There are some CDs out there that have some flexible interest and stuff like that, but predominantly not. But this 2 year CD that has 1 year to go now yields 2%. My 3 year CD that's a year old has 2 years to go. It acts basically the exact same as a 2 year CD, but it's yielding 3%. My 4 year CD has 3 years to go. That yields 4%. My 5 year CD that's a year old has 4 years to go, and it yields 5%. Now what I'm going to do to keep my ladder intact is I'm going to take my $10,000 that I got back my 1 year, and I am going to reinvest it, and I am going to buy another $10,000 5 year CD, and I'll get a rate of return of 5%. So as you can see, my interest rates now start going up. I still got the same flexibility. However, my average interest rate here went up almost a full percent. As time continues, right, when we're in our second year, and we're going to pause for a second and shift our camera. Okay, so we're in our second year now. Our 2 year CD that pays 2% has now matured, and I get my $10,000 back. My 3 year CD that is 2 years old has 1 year to go, so it's going to act the exact same way as a one-year CD, except my yield here is 3%. And my next CD, and basically just everything shifts up. I've got my five-year CD that is 2 years old. It has 3 years to go, but it's earning 5%. My new CD that I purchased here a year ago, when my one-year money matured and it was only earning 1%, I reinvested it for 5 years. Now this one is only 1 year old, and it makes 5%, so it acts the same way as a four-year CD would. I'm then going to take my $10,000. I'm going to reinvest it in a new CD that earns 5%. And obviously, if we take this out another 2 years, then what we're going to have is we're going to maximize our rate of return, and we're going to at the same time be incredibly flexible. One other concept in here, two other concepts, one's called shortening your ladder, the other is called extending your ladder. So extending your ladder is kind of obvious. It's just, I'm going to make this ladder longer. So in year three, we get our $10,000 back. All of these shift up. So now we have one earning 4%. This one earns 5%. Now, we have our $10,000 back here in year three. Extending our ladder basically is we stretch it out. Let's say there's a great year, a great offer for a 7 year CD paying 8%. So I'm going to pull this $10,000 and extend the ladder. Maybe I'll come down here 8 years because it pays 7.5%, and I think that's a good deal. Or maybe I'm going to shorten my ladder because I know I need my money back sooner. And the reason I need my money back sooner is I know I have to put a new roof on my house. I have to buy new plant and equipment. There's a lot of things that I could be doing at this point. And so instead of extending out here to 8 years, what I'm going to do is shorten it, and I'm going to buy a new one-year CD that pays 1%. And the reason I'm doing this, I don't necessarily enjoy the fact that I'm getting only a 1% rate of return, but I know I have demand for my money coming up, so I am going to select a shorter period of time. All right? Now, if we had carried this out without shortening or extending, when we got out here to year five, what we would have had is our 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 year, all paying 5%. And we will have maximized our yield under this situation. One caveat that I want to mention here is obviously interest rates change all the time. Interest rates change daily. They change weekly. And so when we look down at this, realistically, they're all not going to be 5%. That's not going to happen. Because interest rates change, what we might end up with is something like this first one, maybe it's 4.8, 5.2, 5.1. Maybe this year had a horrible year for interest rates, 3.9 and 4.7. So even though we're investing because interest rates go up and down, it's not going to be even 5% all the way across the board, okay, because those change. The other thing that I'd like to mention is that a lot of people get very, very upset at the possibility that they're going to pay what's called an interest penalty. So interest penalties are, I invest my money in a CD for a long period of time, say 5 years, I need that money back, and so I have to pay a penalty to get my money back. I pay an interest penalty. If we have $50,000, if we want to keep everything incredibly flexible, we invested all at 1%, 50,000 times 1% is 500 bucks. If we do the laddering and we spread this ladder out over time and the ladder builds, then we're going to end up with our $50,000 yielding an average of 5%, which means we're going to get $2,500. So by doing this, we're going to make an extra $2,000 each year. Certainly, every once in a while, some disaster is going to happen. Some emergency is going to happen. We're going to lose a job temporarily. We're going to have a combination of one of our kids knocks out their front teeth, the car breaks down, and the water heater breaks all in the same week. And so we're going to need to access some of the deposits at 4 or 5 years. Typically, what you're charged is, in a long-term CD, is about 6 months' worth of interest. So if we're going to break one of our CDs, we're going to break a $10,000 CD, and let's say it's a 5-year CD that's yielding 5%, which means it pays $500 a year. Typically, we're going to be charged a 6-month interest penalty, so we're going to divide this by 2. And we're going to get an interest penalty of $250. Certainly, $250 interest penalty is nothing to sneeze at, and it certainly is real money. However, an awful lot of people get so fixated that they never want to pay a bank penalty, they never want to pay an early withdrawal penalty, that they don't spread out their money over time, and they end up with incredibly low yields. And so people end up very, very short-sighted. Because what would you rather do every year? Would you rather make $500 a year, or would you rather make $2,500 a year and pay a $250 interest penalty every couple years that you run into an emergency? By far, your best option here is to pay the penalty every 2 or 3 years. Shoot, under this system, you can pay a penalty every single year, and you're still $1,750 ahead of the game. And so do not get all caught up on paying a penalty now and then. In the long run, you'll be way ahead. There's a very similar analogy. One of my really good friends, during one of the gas spikes, decided, hey, he's going to sell his truck and buy a car that gets much, much better gas mileage. And so he traded in his truck, he bought another car, and that car saved him about $250 a month in gas. The problem was his car payment was $450 a month, and because it was a new vehicle, his insurance went up about $100 per month. So while he was so fixated on saving a few hundred dollars in gas, which he did, in the end, when he included the car payment and the additional insurance, he lost out. And so, therefore, the same as you've got to look at the overall cost of a vehicle. Maybe you can buy a car for $10,000 less that gets slightly worse gas mileage. Overall, the car with worse gas mileage might be a heck of a lot cheaper. The same thing here. We want to spread this out and take advantage of high interest rates whenever we can. Even if we pay a penalty now and then, we're going to be way, way ahead of the game. So this laddering also is not done only in CDs and only done by individuals. Big corporations do laddering in their cash accounts. And so we'll end up with a company like, say, Home Depot, Intel, General Electric, and sitting in their cash account is maybe $300 million. And they can't take this money and invest it for 6 months or 9 months or 2 years because they have to make payroll. There's seasonal adjustments that take place. Obviously, Home Depot right before Christmas. They put an awful lot of money out to buy an awful lot of things, and then the cash all starts coming in after Christmas. Same with most retail, especially toy stores. And so we can take this $300 million and do laddering within a cash account. And what we're going to do is buy and sell what is called commercial paper. Commercial paper is kind of like these short-term borrowing bond-type instruments between big corporations. So when we look at yields, maybe just sitting here in cash that I can access right now pays me 0.1%. Interest rates certainly are horrible right now. But I can also invest then for 7 days, and maybe I'll get 0.5%. And there's 14-day paper, 21-day paper, 30-day paper, and 45-day paper. Okay? These are some of the common denominations. In fact, there's also a lot of 10-day paper. But we're going to take advantage of almost the exact same yield. And so maybe 14 days pays 0.6, 21 pays 0.7, 30 pays 0.8, and maybe at 45 days, I can get 1%. And so if I can spread this money out over time, because, you know, maybe I'll put a whole bunch of money here at 14 days because I know I have a big payroll to meet. And I know I have some extra money so I can drop $100 million down here at 1%. And I'm going to spread out the other $100 million depending on whatever my demand is. So instead of getting a measly 0.01% on my $300 million, maybe within this system I can actually make 0.5% per year. And 0.5% doesn't necessarily sound like a heck of a lot of money. But if I'm going to get 0.5% of $300 million, right, 10% is 30, 1% is 3, so 0.5% is $1.5 million. So therefore, by using a laddering concept within a cash account, even if I'm just going to nip an extra 0.5%, if there's a lot of money in there, $1.5 million a year, that's a very easy way to pull that off, all right? And that's the end of our concept for laddering.